So the next topic is packaging methods and types of packages. Different packaging methods are used for packing of harvested fruits and vegetables. So what is meant by packaging? It is defined as a mean of system in which fresh produce or processed produce will reach from production center to ultimate consumer in a safe and sound condition at an affordable price. So the packaging is important for the produce can be transferred from production center to the consumer at an affordable price and in a safe condition. Okay, so this is called as packaging. Packaging. One of the more important steps in the long and complicated journey from grower to consumable. Okay, so main function of packaging is to assemble the produce into convenient units for handling. To protect the produce during storage and marketing. So the main function of packaging is first is to assemble the produce into convenient units for handling. Okay, so the packaging material will be very important for the packing of any commodity that can be transferred or that can be sold to the consumer. To protect the produce during storage and marketing. Second one thing is the produce can be stored in the packaging. The packaging material that can be protect the produce from at the time of storage and marketing. Packaging requirement. Product can delay or prevent fresh fruits and vegetables from spoilage. Incorrect packaging can accelerate spoilage. So the packaging material very important that can be prevent or delay the fresh fruits and vegetables from spoilage. Okay. If you use incorrect packaging material, that can be accelerate the spoilage condition. Packaging can serve to protect against contamination, damage, and most important against excess of moisture loss. So this is the important or the requirement of packaging material. Protect fruits and vegetables from pathogens, then size and shape, and the weight limitations. The size and shape and also the weight of packaging material is very important at the time of packaging. So mostly we can use the less or the lightweight packaging material and the shape and size according to our produce. Packaging requirement, they must be non-toxic and compatible with the specific foods. Okay, so it must be non-toxic. And that can be compatible with the specific foods. So according to the produce or the according to the fruits or the vegetables, the packaging material will be used. Sanitary protection, gas and odor protection, light protection, resistant to impact, transparency, appearance and printability, and a low cost. This is the requirement of packaging material. Okay, it should be at the time of packaging or the packaging material will be clean, okay, disease free and dust free. That is the sanitary protection and gas and odor protection from the gas, the respiration rate at the time of screen. It is visible. Hello, screen is visible.
Hi, ma'am. आता नहीं है मैम.
ओके ओके. ओके एंड इट शुड बी रेजिस्टेंट टू डिसीजेस पेस्ट एटसेट्रा. ओके एंड अपीयरेंस एंड ट्रांसपेरेंसी. द पैकेजिंग मटेरियल विल बी ट्रांसफर or the appearance and printability. That means the product, which type of produce are packed in the packaging material. So it will be transparent. Okay, that can be see the what type of product can be product are packed in packet in packet. Okay, and it should be low cost. This is the requirement of packaging. Several types of packaging fresh products. Okay, so different types of packaging materials are used for the packing of fruits and vegetables. So the first is the natural materials. This is the natural materials. Woods, pallets, bead, wire bound crates, wooden crates and lugs, wooden baskets and hampers, corrugated fiber board. This is the natural material. Pulp containers, paper and mesh bags, plastic bags, shrink wrap, rigid plastic package, plastic fiber boxes, vacuum packaging, modified atmospheric packaging, and controlled atmosphere. So this is shrink wrap, rigid plastic package, plastic filled boxes, then vacuum packing and modified atmospheric packing. This is the new packaging material recently used for the packing of fruits and vegetables. So the first one is the natural materials. Okay, in the natural materials, basket and other traditional containers are made from bamboo, rattan, then straw, palm leaves. This is the natural material, okay, naturally available for the packing of fruits and vegetables. Bamboo, rattan, then straw, palm leaves. And disadvantages of this material is they are difficult to clean when contaminated with decay organism. Okay, so contamination is more in this material. The lack of rigidity and bend out of shape when stuck for longer distance transport. Okay, so the breaking of material, packing material can be, the chances is it will be high at the time of transportation at a long distance. They load badly because of their shape. Okay, so this material having no specific shape. Okay, so load of material very high. So the breaking chances it will be more. The cause pressure damage when tightly filled, they often have a shape edges and splinters causing cut and punctures damage. Okay, the damage at the time of transportation, damage chances it will be more. Next one is the wood pallets. Wood pallets, the pallets are built as inexpensively as possible and discarded after a single use. Okay, so this material may be one time, and that can be discarded after the use of material. Then pallet bins are primarily used to improve the produce from field or orchard to the packing house. So this is the pallet bin. In this picture we can see the pallet bin, and this pallet bin mostly used for the product transfer from field to the packing house. Okay, then wooden wire bound crates. Okay, this is in this picture. This is the wire bound crates. Okay, wooden wire bound crates are used for commodities that require hydrocooling. For the hydrocooling, mostly wire bound crates are used. Okay, this is wire bound crates are sturdy, rigid, and have very high stacking strength. These are not generally acceptable for consumers, packing because of the difficulty in affixing a suitable labels. Okay, so this is these crates are not mainly used for the consumers packing. Okay, because it is difficult in affixing suitable labels. Okay, the structure, this is wire bound crates. The crates are bound with wire, so that's why the we cannot take a proper label on that packing. Wooden crates and lugs. Okay, this is wooden crates. Okay, once extensively used for apple, stone fruits and potatoes, have been almost totally replaced by other types of containers. This is mostly used for the stone fruits and potatoes. Advance in material handling have reduced their use to a few specialty items such as expensive tropical fruits. Okay, so handling of this packing is easy and mostly used for the tropical fruits and the stone fruits and potatoes. Wooden basket and hampers. Okay, in this picture we can see the wooden baskets and hampers. Okay, wooden baskets and hampers used for wide variety of crops. They are durable and nested for efficient transport when empty. Okay, so however, cost, disposal problems and difficulty in efficient palletization have severely limited their use to mostly local grower markets, where they may be reused many times. So this is the long lasting material mostly used for the reused for packing of fruits and vegetables. Okay, and transportation, the cost is very low, and disposal, disposal problem. And disadvantages is difficulty in efficient palletization. Okay, palletization, that means the transferring of material from one vehicle to another vehicle, or the at the time of loading. Okay, corrugated fiber board. Corrugated fiber board is manufactured in many different styles and weights. Because of its relativity, low cost and versatility, it is the dominant produce container material and will probably remain so in the near futures. Both cold temperature and high humidity reduce the strength of fiberboard containers. Unless the containers is specially treated, moisture absorbed from the surrounding air and contents can reduce the strength of container. So this corrugated fiberboard mostly used for the controlling the or maintaining the temperature and relative humidity at the time of storing of fruits and vegetables. And that material can be absorb excess moisture surrounding the air. Okay, and the containers can be treated, specially treated with different chemicals for increasing the shelf life of produce. Cabbage, melons, potatoes, pumpkins, and citrus have all been shipped successfully in this container. Okay, the container cost per produce is as little as 1/4 of traditional, and the size of containers, some bulk containers may be collapsed and reused. Okay, so this is the fiber board, corrugated fiber board, and mostly used for the cabbage, melons, potatoes, pumpkins, etc., and that can be reused for the packing of fruits and vegetables. And cost is very low. Then pulp containers. Pulp containers made from recycled paper pulp and starch binder are mainly used for small consumers' packages of fresh produce. Okay, so pulp containers are made from replaced paper pulp and starch binder. And this is mainly used for the small consumer packages. Pulp containers are available in the large variety of shapes and size, and relatively inexpensive in a standard size, and can absorb surface moisture from the produce are also biodegradable, made from recycled material and recyclable. Okay, this is recyclable material that can be used many times, and it can be absorbed the surface moisture from the produce. Paper and mesh bags, consumers packs of potatoes and onions are about the only produce types now pack in a mesh bags. Okay, this picture, mesh bag. Okay, and this mesh bag mostly used for the storing of potatoes and onions. It is low cost material, and mesh has the advantages of inhibiting the airflow. Good ventilation is particularly beneficial to onions. Okay, so this material is very useful for the storing of onion and potatoes. Ventilation is good in this material, and supermarket produce managers like small mesh bags because they make attractive displays that stimulate purchase. Have several serious disadvantages. Large bags do not palletize well, and small bags do not efficiently fill the space inside corrugated firewood containers. Okay, this is the disadvantages. Large bag cannot be palletized well, and small bag cannot be efficiently fill the space inside the corrugated fiberboard container. Bag do not offer protection from rough handling. Okay, so this is the disadvantages. Bags cannot be offer protection from rough handling. Mesh bags provide a little protection from light and contaminants. Plastic bags, polyethylene film are the predominant material of fruits and vegetables consumers packaging. Besides the very low material cost, automated bagging machines further reduce packaging cost. Film bags are clear, allowing for easy inspection of the contents and ready accept high quality graphics. Plastic bags. So this is the plastic bags mostly used for the vegetable storing of vegetables, and this is high quality low cost material, but the chances of breaking off this plastic bags it will be more. Next one is the shrink wrap. Shrink wrapping has been used successfully to package potatoes, sweet potatoes, apples, onions, sweet corns. Okay, this is the new technique of packaging shrink wrap, mostly used for the packing of potatoes, sweet potatoes, apple, onion, sweet corn. Shrink wrapping with the engineered plastic wrap can reduce the shrinkage, protect the produce from the disease, reduce mechanical damage, and provide a good surface for stick-on labels. So in this picture we can see the how packed the fruits and vegetables in this packing. Shrink, okay, reduce the shrinkage, or the plastic wrap with the produce. Okay, rigid plastic package with top and bottom that are heat form from one or two piece of plastics are known as clamshells. Clamshells are most often used with consumers packs of high value produce items like small fruit, berries, and mushroom. Rigid plastic package are mostly used for the packing of small fruits, berries, and mushroom. In this packing method, rigid plastic material are used top and bottom. Okay, that are heat form from one or two pieces of plastics. Then plastic filled boxes are usually made of polyvinyl chloride and polyethylene. they are durable and can last many years. Okay, so this is the plastic filled boxes. In locally we called as plastic crates. Okay, they are designed in such way that they can nest inside each other when empty to facilitate transport, and that and can nest inside each other when empty to facilitate transport. Next one, control atmosphere. This is the new technique of packing. This refers to a storage atmosphere that is different from the normal atmosphere in its composition, wherein the component gases are precisely adjusted to specific concentration and maintained throughout the storage and distribution of the perishable foods. Okay, controlled atmosphere, that means the controlling atmospheric condition. Okay, at the time of storage, the different from the normal atmosphere. Okay, at controlling the atmosphere at the time of storage, and that is different from the normal atmosphere. Control atmosphere relies on that the continuous measurement of the composition of storage atmosphere and injection of the appropriate gases or the gas mixtures into it, and if and when needed. Okay, so in this packaging, the control atmosphere, we can inject the appropriate gas or the gases mixture into it if needed. Okay. Hence, the system requires sophisticated instruments to monitor the gas level, and is therefore practical only for refrigerated bulk storage and shipment of commodities in a large containers. In this packing, required sophisticated instrument to monitor the gas level. Okay. And it is there for the practical only for the refrigerated bulk storage. The tomato excessively low CO2 and high CO2 prevents proper ripening even after removal of the fruit to air, and control atmosphere enhances the danger of chilling injury. Okay, so according to the commodity, we can adjust the gas level, temperature requirement, and relative humidity. Okay, for the tomato, excessively required low O2 and high CO2. That can be prevents the proper ripening even after the removal of the fruit to air. Next one is the modified atmospheric packaging. In this packaging, modified atmosphere containing between 2 to 5% of oxygen and 3.8% of carbon dioxide have been shown to extend the shelf life of the wide variety of fruits and vegetables. So the main principle of modified atmospheric packaging is to maintain the oxygen level and carbon dioxide level, 2 to 5% of oxygen and 3.8% of carbon dioxide. In the shelf life of commodity at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius is one by employing modified atmospheric packaging, it will be doubled. Okay, the shelf life of commodity at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius is one, and okay, if the temperature is 20 to 25 degrees Celsius, the shelf life that can be employed double. Okay, whereas refrigeration can extend the shelf life 2-3 times. If the commodity stored in a refrigerator, that can extend the shelf life 3 times as compared to the normal temperature. And refrigeration combined with modified atmospheric can increase into the 4. Okay, that means if you take any commodity in normal temperature, that can be the shelf life is 1 day. Okay, in a normal temperature, and it can be stored in a refrigerator that the temperature that shelf life it will be 3 days. And if the commodity can be stored in a modified atmospheric packaging condition, that can be the shelf life extend up to 2 days. And if the refrigeration and combined with modified atmospheric packaging, the shelf life can be increased up to the 4 days. Okay. Few types of films are routinely used for modified atmospheric packaging. Polypropylene. Okay. Which type of material used in a modified atmospheric packaging are polyvinyl chloride, polystyrene, polyethylene, and polypropylene. Okay. Modified atmospheric condition are created inside the package by the commodity itself or by active modification. Active modification involves creating a slight vacuum inside the packages and replacing it with a desired moisture, desired mixture of gases, so as to establish a desired EMA and quickly compose to passively generated EMA, that is ethylene modified atmosphere. Okay. Another active modification techniques is the use of carbon dioxide or to prevent the buildup of the particular gas within the package. Next one is the another active modification technique is to use of carbon dioxide or ethyl absorbers, okay, that is called as scavengers within the packages to prevent the buildup of particular gases within the packages. Okay, this question can be asked in objective, which type of scavengers are used in packages, okay, or absorbers. This method is called as active packaging. Compounds like hydrated lime, activated charcoal, then magnesium oxides are known to as absorb carbon dioxide, while iron powder is known to absorb carbon dioxide. Okay, so the carbon dioxide absorbers are hydrated lime, activated charcoal, magnesium oxides. Then potassium permanganate and phenyl methyl silicon can be used to absorb ethylene within the packages. Okay, so potassium magnet or the phenyl methyl silicon are used to absorb the ethylene. Okay, the scavengers can be held in the small sachet within the post harvest management and value addition fruits and vegetables. So this is the for example, the carbon dioxide absorbers or the potassium or ethylene absorbers are available in the small sachets. Okay, and that can be sachets are used in a use at the time of packaging. Next one is the vacuum packaging. Vacuum packaging offers an extensive barriers against corrosion, oxidation, moisture, drying out, dirt, attraction of dust by electric arc, ultraviolet rays, and mechanical damage, fungus growth, and perishability. This is the new technique of packaging, vacuum packaging. Mostly are the main objective of use of vacuum packaging is to extensive barrier against corrosion, oxidation, moisture, drying out, dirt, attraction of dust by electric arc, then ultraviolet rays and mechanical damage, and also the fungus growth. In vacuum packaging, the product to be packed is put in the vacuum bags made of special hermetic fills that is then evacuated in a vacuum chamber and then sealed hermetically in order to provide a total barrier against air and moisture. Okay, this is the vacuum packaging. Vacuums are in vacuum packaging, the product to be packed in is put in a vacuum bags. Okay, and that can be prevents the barrier against moisture and air. If some of the products cannot bear the atmosphere pressure due to the vacuum inside the packages, then the package are flush with inert gas like nitrogen and CO2 after evacuation. Okay, so if the some product can cannot bear the atmospheric pressure due to vacuum inside the package, inside the package, then the package are flush with inert gas like nitrogen and CO2 after evacuation. Next one is the edible packaging. An edible film or coating is simply defined as thin continuous layer of edible material formed on place on or between the foods or food component. Edible material. Some edible material are also used for coating of produce. Okay, with the thin continuous layer of edible material. That can be on the place of foods or between the foods. Okay, this is called as edible packaging. Selection of material for in edible packaging is based on its properties to act as a barrier to moisture and gases, mechanical strength, physical properties, and resistant to microbial growth. This is the main objectives of edible packaging is to barrier against moisture, gases, mechanical strength, physical properties, and resistant to microbial growth. The types of material used for edible packaging includes lipids, proteins, polysaccharides, and combination of any two or all of this. Okay. Always keep it in mind, edible packaging material for the packing of for the edible packaging, the material includes is lipid, proteins, polysaccharides. Okay, lipid, proteins, and polysaccharides. Many lipid compounds such as animal and vegetable fats, acetoglycerides have been used in the formulation of edible packaging for fresh fruits, fresh produce because of their excellent moisture barrier properties. Okay. Many lipid compounds like animal and vegetable fats, acetoglycerides are also used in the formulation of edible packaging. Lipid coatings on fresh fruits and vegetables reduce the weight loss due to dehydration during storage by 40 to 70%. Okay, weight loss at the time of storing. Then grape guards. Grape guards are chemically treated paper sheets using active ingredients, that is anhydrous sodium bisulfite. Okay, this is the chemical formula, Na2S2O5. Okay, anhydrous sodium bisulfite. This is mainly used for the grapes, packing of grapes. Grape guards are chemically treated paper sheet using active ingredients. Grape guard paper is a special chemically treated cellulosic antifungal paper that regulates their release of SO2 concentration at around 80 ppm for over 20 weeks at a time in each individual carton of grapes. Okay, so the concentration of SO2 for storing a 12 weeks is 80 ppm. Okay, at in each individual carton of grapes, individual the grapes individual grape box. Okay, individual cartons required 80 ppm for storing of for storing 12 weeks. Their function is to preserve the quality of grapes in a store and transist by control of decay. Okay, the function of grape guard is to preserve the quality at the time of store and transist by control of decay. Grape guards improve the quality by containing sturdy, bright, unshriveled appearance of fruits. Okay, so the grape guards can improve the quality of grapes. They are available in two types: quick release grape guard retards decay development up to 3 weeks at 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, there are two types of grape guards are available. First one is a quick release and second one is a dual release. So the first one, quick release, is to retard the decay development up to 3 weeks at 0 degrees Celsius, and it can help for a few days to control decay without refrigeration. And dual release grape guard can be stored, can be used for decay retardation up to 12 weeks and store or a transist with refrigeration facilities. It is also effective only 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, this is dual release, can be stored 12 weeks. Then corrugated fiberboard boxes, three ply with capacity of 2 kg and 5 kg having dimension of 25, 20 and 12 cm is being used for packaging. Different packaging materials like craft paper, butter paper and soft tissue paper for preparation of grape guards is used. Grape guard containing 6 to 9 grams of sodium bisulfate is used. Okay, bisulfate 6 to 9 grams. Berry decay and berry drop was controlled by the use of grape guards with containing 9 grams of sodium bisulfate. Okay, so the berry drop or the berry decay at the time of storing, so that can be at the time of storing can be occur. So that can be prevented by use of 9 gram of sodium bisulfate. Grape guards containing sodium bisulfate extend the shelf life of Thompson seedless, Anabishai, Dilkush, Sharad seedless grapes up to 14, 8, 8 and 16 days respectively. Okay, at an ambient temperature up to degrees up to the 75, 68 days respectively under cold condition. In ambient temperature is 70, 60, 75, 85. So if you use the sodium bisulfate in a grape guards, that can be extend the shelf life. Okay, then this is all about packaging material used for the packing of fruits and vegetables. Next one is the cushioning material. The function of cushioning material is to fix the commodities inside the packages and prevent them from mixing about in a relation to each other and package itself when there is a vibration or impact. Okay, the main function of cushioning material is to fix the commodity inside the packages, and that can be prevent them from the mixing about in relation to each other and also package itself when it is there in vibration or at the time. So the cushioning material is important at the time of transportation. The cushioning material are used inside the packages. Okay, to reduce the vibration within the packages of produce or the fruits or the vegetables. Some cushioning material can also provide the packages with additional staking strength. The cushioning materials are used vary with the commodity and may be made of wrapping papers, fiberboard, single or double wall, molded paper pulp trays, molded foam, polystyrene, ट्रेस, मोल्डेड प्लास्टिक ट्रेस, फोम प्लास्टिक शीट्स, प्लास्टिक बबल पैड्स, फाइन श्रेडेड वुड्स, प्लास्टिक फिल्म्स, इनर्स और द बैग्स, कंट्रोल्स एंड मॉडिफाइड एटमोस्फेयर पैकिंग. दिस इज द कुशनिंग मटेरियल. डिफरेंट कुशनिंग मटेरियल्स आर यूज्ड फॉर द पैकिंग ऑफ कमोडिटी. Okay, so this is all about the packing, packaging of fruits and vegetables, different methods of packaging, types of packaging and cushioning material. Different types of cushioning materials are used for the packing of fruits and vegetables. Okay, samajhle ka sarvanna?